Hey everybody, call me Felix, and we found the best pizza in the Philippines in an unlikely place, El Nido, Palawan. Not just the best pizza in the Philippines, it's a world-class pizza from a world-class tourist destination. Before we dive into the best pizza on our El Nido trip thus far, we'll have to recap our run-in last time eating the scariest Filipino food around. Last time on our El Nido food trip, we dared to eat the tamilok, or mangrove woodworm, during our island-hopping trip lunch. This unique delicacy tastes a lot better than its unappealing appearance of raw fermented squid guts suggests, as it tastes like a smoky oyster mixed with pungent mushrooms aged in an oak barrel. Cousin JP and I found that the tamilok tastes even better with a generous helping of Tabasco sauce, as it drowns out some of that smokiness with an acidic spice bite before finishing with a persistently woodsy aftertaste. We tend to prefer our tamilok with Tabasco instead of this local way of dipping the tamilok in coconut vinegar. So, if you come to Palawan, you have to try tamilok and bring a bottle of Tabasco with you. That's your trust exercise homework, people. Eat your tamilok with Tabasco. If you want to see our El Nido adventures thus far, click on the far right-hand corner for the El Nido Master Playlist. We continued on that day, visiting the Big Lagoon and Seven Commandos Beach with no other tourists to share them with. And we have to say, we were living the good life with no one else around. Once back to shore, we resumed our never-ending pursuit for the best pizza we could find. Little did we know that our walk through some side streets and alleyways would lead us to world-beating pizza. The kind you go up to Napoli or New York with and say, "That's a damn good pie." The place is called Bella Vita, an open-facing restaurant to a lovely sunset beach view by the doorstep. And it's the kind of place you'd think is mainly about remarkable ambiance, but not so fast. We found amazing food all the way around. Our appetizer started with a legit insalata burrata, sporting imported burrata cheese and fresh arugula. It was a tasty prelude to the three pizzas we ordered, a mouth-watering truffle pizza with mushrooms and Parma ham, the most amazing pepperoni pizza we've had in the Philippines by far, and a Margherita pizza that was stunning in its simplicity. To close things off, we had a rich, well-balanced tiramisu for dessert. By a clear margin, this meal was one of the all-time best we had on the vlog, and incredibly, it was from a beachside pizzeria in El Nido. Without further ado, here's our review on Bella Vita. Enjoy. Okay, after another long day of island hopping in which we saw the super secret island, it took us a while to get here. Well, we are here. We're at an Italian restaurant called Bella Vita. Yes. And it took us a while to walk down a few side streets to get here. But we're here enjoying the last remnants of sunset. And so this beautiful seaside restaurant.
Very quaint restaurant, very homey.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And they have specialties in Napolitano food from Italy. So here we have insalata burrata. Now how in the world do you get this over here? Like this ball of mozzarella and all that.
Yeah, I know.
A lot of looks like balsamic and then some arugula and some tomato. Sorry, tomato. So let's dive right in to our appetizer, which looks very colorful. The type way I would expect insalata burrata to look like. Huh? Yes. Let's get a little bit
of vinegar with some
cherry tomatoes.
Arugula. Ooh, yum and yum.
Yeah. Very traditional. Very traditional salad from southern Italy. Okay, there we go. It's really like a gentle nuttiness all around that salad. The creaminess, a little bit of sweetness from those tomatoes, really sweet. The arugula adding some pepperiness. Really fresh starter.
Very fresh.
And of course the cheese makes it a little bit richer, but good way to open the meal. We're looking forward to three pizzas, everyone. And we've been on the hunt for pizza, especially here in El Nido, but this might be the best one. Because look at all, because the ingredients just made us salivate, basically. Mm-hmm. Authentic Italian pizza.
The way it's described on their menu sounds delicious. It's not just like, okay, this is it, and then you're disappointed at the... So yeah. Hoping that it's not going to be one of those.
Exactly. Okay, pizza time coming up. The first pizza has arrived. It's the tartufata. This tells you there should be some truffle in here.
It's delicious.
There's some parts. There's some mushroom on it as well. And then
Parmigiano Reggiano.
Parmigiano Reggiano. And then there's some Parma ham, I think. Slices of Parma ham. Mm-hmm. Honest to goodness, Italian Parma ham.
Look at the char on the crust.
It's beautiful.
It is.
This now, is here's the real the acid test, yeah.
Ooh, there's another one. Ooh, yum.
That's a Diavolo pizza with some pepperoni. Yes. Supposed to be spicy. Like real Italian pepperoni.
Ooh, yum.
What shall we dig into first?
Let's try the first one.
Okay. Let's do that. Ooh. And I think this is a knife and fork job. Unless you're gonna...
Well, unless you try New York style, fold it.
Yeah. We're not from New York, everybody, but we're gonna do it New York style. New York style. Fold it like that. Like a New Yorker does it. Oh, you're gonna do it that way? Okay.
We'll try this both ways. Okay, so you try that way, I'll try this way.
Okay.
Yeah, go.
What are you gonna do, Warren, with your hands?
We do it together. We all take the bite together, guys.
2-1.
Yeah.
Ready?
Did New York.
Oh my gosh, I just licked my finger.
Oh
and
my
I
goodness.
It's a truffle.
Whiff of that. Toast. Cheers.
Mmm, God.
Mmm.
We found the place. Right? Mmm.
That truffle flavor. Mm-hmm. The first moment you actually put it in your mouth and not even bite into it, you get that truffle essence already.
Mm-hmm.
Arugula adds the freshness, a little more pepperiness.
The richness of that truffle
the salt,
oil.
Mm. And the cheese, also. It's really, really good. Mm-hmm. You can tell this is high quality pizza from the charring on the sides,
yeah.
Too.
We found the place.
We found a really good place.
We found a really good pizza place. Okay, all right. And we're only onto our first pizza.
Mm-hmm. And honest to goodness, good Parma ham on there. Yeah. Mm. Yeah. This gentle truffle and cheese flavor. Arugula. Saltiness from the ham. And that dough. Has some chew to it, but then
yeah, it's good
really it has to have chew.
It's got that chew. It's a
but it's still chew. Soft, like good dough should be. Mm. Mm. Really enjoying that. Mm. Anything, Warren?
Yeah, I like the cheese and mushrooms. Everything on it.
Mm-hmm. Looks like he got some white sauce from the cheese too, all the way up to his sideburns. Oh no, that's just suntan lotion. Yeah, or is it suntan lotion? I hope it is.
Sunblock.
Yeah, whatever. Same difference. Okay. Hmm. Really good. And then there's extra mushroom in here to add the more umami essence. I don't think you need to put anything. I think a little Tabasco would make it even better.
Mm. I should try this, but it's not that hot.
No chili oil? Nah, Tabasco it is. Some people are gonna say you're gonna sully up a good pizza if you put some Tabasco.
Mm. I think it might work with this.
I think it will. But I think it will work even better with that pepperoni pizza.
Yep.
Let's do that then.
Next.
Mm-hmm.
You want to try it by itself before?
Yeah.
Okay. You trust me?
Mm-hmm.
I'm giving this to you. My fans are clean. Oh my god, it's hot!
Okay, that's a knife and fork job, I guess. Okay, time to have our Diavolo pizza. I took this knife job and I said, forget this. I'm going to just do it in my hand. Okay.
Toast.
Toast. There we go.
Oh my god.
Mmm. The basil. Fresh basil.
Amazing. Wow.
Mm. Actually, this is the owner's favorite.
Yeah. This is the
simple pepperoni pizza. I was like, really?
We're like, what? Really? He's like, yeah. Okay. So now, yeah, we know why.
It's actually known on the menu as the Diavolo pizza. You know, the devil, right? But Pepperoni is coming a little spicy. Mm. Not the right spice. JP's all thumbs up about this one.
I love this one. Mm. Wow. Mm. You've been searching for a good pizza. This is it.
Yeah, this is a really good legit pizza. Mm-hmm. Legit Napolitano pizza. Wow. Mm. And I bet we're still hungry from eating Tommy's look and Tungige for lunch, everybody. So, yeah, there's just a little bit of a heat there, but ooh, there's like a roasty meat, like a roasted meat flavor with that pepperoni too. So the pepperoni itself too is quite good, like different.
Oh, it's by itself, it's delicious.
It's also different compared to other pepperoni.
It's the best pepperoni I've tasted so far.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah, Philippines.
Mm-hmm. I wouldn't even say it's up to snuff with American pepperoni because it has like a, there's something about it that's like smoky and roasty.
Thank God the sauce isn't sweet because I would go crazy if it was.
This is a true Italian pizza.
Truly.
Mm-hmm. True Italian. And that's a margherita with the buffalo mozzarella cheese. Oh my great good God. Oh, it stretches. Look at that thing. Now, they have a regular margherita pizza, but this one looks legit because they use buffalo mozzarella. Look how stretchy that is.
I know, it's delicious. Warren?
Thanks.
Crust? Oh. How come you're not eating it?
I've even
so
higher.
I need more.
So given the quality of the two pizzas, the truffle and the pepperoni, I have really high hopes for this margherita. It's a simple pizza, but if you do it so well, it's something you'll remember.
It could be like amazing, yeah. Let's see.
Mm. Ready? Yeah, one, let's go. And... 1, 2, and 3. Mmm. Mm, like an extra creaminess. Mm, that buffalo milk. I'm gonna get closer to it. Yeah.
This is the spot.
Mm. Look at the char mark underneath too. That's so ideal. We're looking for good pizza because chewy charred dough. Mm. I really love it.
Really good.
Mm-hmm. Creamy, chewy cheese. Fresh basil. Just get a nice toastiness. So it brings out a bit of more roasted notes. Mm. Yeah, they found a really good place, everyone. I think this is the one place.
One place. And you know what? We found this by accident. We were going to another place. They were closed. And then...
That's really popular here in El Nido.
Our guide, or our tricycle guide, told us to come here, and we're like, it's quite a walk to get in from the parking lot. So it's like it's like a maze.
You have to go through a few side streets to get
but
here.
But it's worth it.
Mm-hmm. My goodness, pizza is really, really good. It's just like really good quality, amazing quality, best in the Philippines we've had. Mm-hmm. Here in El Nido, at Bella Vita, down the
beach.
How
is it with your wine? Is it a pairing?
Let's try it here with this French wine. Yeah, because with the doughiness here, kind of finishes clean, and it actually lifts the sweetness too. This the pizza. Yeah, it brings out more sweet peppery notes too.
This
the
one.
Cabernet.
Yeah. Mm.
Wow.
I think I might have one.
So all of the pizzas here, pan. Flippin' fantastic.
Delicious.
I can't pick a favorite.
I can't say anything bad about it. It's like, it's so freaking good.
And I can't pick a favorite between the three either.
Yeah, I like them all.
I love them all for different reasons. Mm-hmm. Amazing. Amazing, guys. Amazing pizza. I think we should get some dessert to kind of... I want a good tiramisu. I hope there is one.
I'm sure that if this is the quality of their food right here, the desserts must be great too.
Awesome. Okay, everyone. We're gonna enjoy the rest of these pizzas. I think we're gonna finish it all because we're that hungry. It's gonna be good. Amazing. Okay.
Don't lie. Okay. Good.
Best movie meal in El Nido we've had so far.
Yes.
Best meal. Two thumbs Hell up from yeah. JP. Yeah. Yes. We finally.
Bella Vita. Bella Vita.
Mm-hmm.
Come.
In our hunt for great pizza, in our hunt for good pizza or if acceptable yeah. pizza, we found great.
We've been disappointed so many times. This place, mm-hmm. within this first pizza, already brought up, lifted up, elevated yeah. everything.
Amazing. Amazing. Okay. We're going to enjoy it. Leave us alone. Bye bye. And the last thing we try here is they didn't have a dessert menu. So it's like, but I really want some tiramisu. And as it turns out, they have a dessert pizza or tiramisu. Guess what I was in the mood for? Yes, tiramisu. In this lovely glass. Espresso at the top. Mascarpone. There we go. It's heavenly. That's nicely rich. Quite creamy. More on the creamy side, I would say. I'm trying to get more of those lady fingers on the bottom. Okay. Yeah, it's rich. It's not like, you know how espresso kind of adds that bitter? It's just like more chocolatey, creamy. Let's see what JP thinks about this.
Let me see.
Yeah.
Wow. Wow.
Rich, isn't it?
But it's not sweet.
But it's not sweet.
Yeah, it's perfect, like, creaminess. It's really good.
Mm-hmm. Is that a little bittersweet chocolate there?
Mm. Wow. Yeah.
Trying to get more of those lady fingers at the bottom. Not a lot. It's just a lot of, like, mascarpone. Whipped cream. It's a... Yeah. Chocolate. Really awesome. Mm.
It's one of those, you know how you get... You know how when you're eating something you want to dance while you're eating it?
Yeah.
This is one of those. It's like...
Mmm. Yeah. So...
Yeah, that's pretty hard.
Hard so, stuff. We gotta come back to Bella Vita before we leave El Nido, don't we?
Yeah.
It's a must restaurant, it's everyone. When you're here...
You gotta visit that twice.
The view... The view is awesome. Of course, it's at night. For the beach.
Yeah.
But...
The food is so good.
I mean, usually
for, so the, good, guys.
Usually for the ambiance, you don't expect the food to be like amazing, but it really is. I was not expecting amazing. I was thinking it was like, going to be okay.
It's really, really good.
Yeah.
It's yeah. really good.
It's amazing. So this is a must try when you're in El Nido, everyone. Must try.
It's homemade by the chef. I mean, homemade, right? By the chef.
Yeah.
But they usually run out of this, so luckily we were able to get some.
Mm-hmm.
So... Wow,
and this is like the best place to go after island hopping.
Mm.
One day of island hopping, and this is really treating yourself. And let me just say, pizza's very reasonably priced. 12 inches, like no more than 500 pesos.
It's really good.
Really, really good. So do come out here. It's a must try when you're here.
It's not sweet. I love that. I love the fact that it's not sweet. I mean, it's sweet, but it's just like the right amount. It's not overbearing. It's not.
No. It does not cloying either. No cloying aftertaste.
I'll probably eat like three of these.
Oh, don't tempt me.
It's so
don't
good.
Don't tempt me at all.
My don't goodness. Do it. Don't do it. We'll come back again.
And order like two of them.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Mm. So good. So everyone, this is a really must. A must. It's a destination. Here in El Nido.
Yeah. Come here, guys, seriously.
Bella Vita.
And if we rarely say, hey, you know what, you have to make it over here, this is it.
Worth the trip.
Bella Vita.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Good life.
And really, even better after a day of island hopping, this is the perfect way to cap it off.
Yeah, really. Want to refresh yourself. Look how red my face is from the sun. This is making it so much cooler.
Mmm, so good. All right, guys, well, on to the next video, I think. There you go.
Next time on our El Nido food trip, we're going to taste the other exotic food Palawan is known for, bird's nest soup. And appropriately, we're in the most famous place for bird's nests, given that El Nido translates into English as the nest. Locals risk their lives, fetching swallows' nests perched high inside the many karst limestone caves, and they fetch a high export price tag too, for the swallows' nest's supposed medicinal qualities. Such an abysmally modest ingredient turned luxury item might just be best served by a restaurant housed in a luxe resort frequented by celebrities. And it just so happens we're getting our bird's nest soup cooked here, paluto style, meaning that we bought the bird's nest outside and we're getting the chef to cook the bird's nest soup. Did we find a tasty interpretation of bird's nest soup here in El Nido? Well, find out on the next installment of our El Nido food trip. And so, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up as that helps a lot. And better yet, subscribe for more of our food and travel adventures to come. Until next time, keep cool but care, and remember, the empire never ended.